Hey guys, welcome to episode 15 of the Trail Project. Now before we get into the main focus of this video, the new servo, really impressed, really strong, performed really well, and the new servo horn, well the new plastic servo horn actually lasted the whole of my trip to Black Rocks in Matlock. It didn't strip out at all, didn't have to replace it, so really happy with that. I am still going to put an aluminium one in there, but for now that plastic one will do as fine. But yeah, really impressed with the new servo. However, I grenaded the transmission pretty bad. Now unfortunately I wasn't actually filming any trailing going on there. I just wanted to run the truck. So I did take some photos which I'll overlay here. But it's a fantastic location for some trailing. Some really spectacular views and some great trailing spots and some crawling spots. But yeah, with a fully tightened slipper clutch and stock plastic gears, I fully expected this to strip out at some point, and I'm glad I did it before the G6 at the end of the month. But yeah, that is one broken transmission. As you can see, I can freewheel the truck. It's not even turning the motor. Yeah, that is completely grenaded. I did make it back to the car though, although it was making some very unpleasant noises, but I did make it back to the car. It just had no drag brake and it sounded awful. So yeah, we're going to strip this out today, see what the problem is and put some new upgraded parts in. Now the only thing that holds this transmission in is the motor plugs, motor wires and four screws in the skid plate. So it's really simple and easy to take out. So we're going to get the transmission out and then see what damage I've done. Apart. Ooh, the gears are full now. I've got gloves on just to protect my hands from the grease. But oh yeah, there we go. There is the stripped gear. That is properly mangled. Every single tooth is pretty much gone. Now that's the idler gear. That is the most common to go because it does mesh with a metal gear. So the first one that's going to go is the idler gear, not this one. But yeah, I was just with a fully tightened slipper clutch, the wheels got caught up and I pressed the throttle and it just stripped one, and as soon as you strip one you're going to strip them all. So yes, that's the reason for broken transmission, stripped idler gear. But we have upgrades and I'm glad it happened before the G6 and not during the G6, because I probably wouldn't have been able to continue. But yeah, we're going to get all this swapped out for some nice new stuff, and we're going to have a bulletproof transmission. But the only other problem that I noticed was this. This is the locked spool in the bottom of the transmission, and that screw is loose. That screw there is getting there, and that screw there is loose. So all three of those screws were loose, so had I run this truck anymore, I think one of these would have backed off completely and broken the transmission anyway. So yeah, I'll be putting way more Loctite on those in the future. But yeah, if one of those screws had come undone, it would have travelled around the transmission and really screwed it up. So yeah, definitely Loctite those when you're building the transmission. But I have separated all these bearings apart, I'll be reusing these, they're all fine. Just taking all the plastic remnants and grease off, I'll be reusing them in the new transmission. For a bulletproof transmission, I've gone for the Axial machined steel gear set. quite expensive, and I've had it sitting around for a while because I knew I was going to strip out that idler gear. We've got a Boomracing transmission case with the mounting hardware included, and we've got a Boomracing aluminium skid plate. So these two items, plus another couple of bits, I got as a complete set off of Facebook. It was really, really cheap. Some guy had bought them for his SCX10 and they didn't want them, so I was selling them at a really good price. So yeah, these gears aren't going to strip out anytime soon. If anything, I'm going to be breaking drive shafts, which are a lot easier and simpler to fix and a lot cheaper than transmission parts. So I'd rather have that as a weak link rather than a transmission gear or spur gear or anything like that. So yeah, we're going to get this built up and installed into the SCX10. Currently running the dog bone drive cup setup, and I've got a lot more steering angle, and I was noticing it was binding up a little bit at the front, so I've just opted to install these heavy duty universal drive shafts. So yeah, I'm going to get these installed today, and that'll be it for upgrades for the foreseeable future. skipping ahead quite a considerable amount of time, I've actually been to the G6 and ran some of the courses there. Truck performed fantastically, and since the last little clip you saw of me changing to the heavy duty fast tracks universal drive shafts, I have also remade all of the battery tray and electronics tray out of 2mm stainless steel. Again, being a fabricator welder, I was able to do this at work on the brake press, and also involved a little bit of welding as well. So I've got, it's basically the same setup that I had last time. Got a battery tray here, and this is exactly the same width and length as my Orion 4500mAh shorty packs that are my favourite battery to go for. You can see I've actually added a back plate to this electronics tray just to protect it from the dust and any rocks and stuff that kick up. But yeah, I made that back portion there, welded it on. So you can see down there, so that is that back plate that I made. So the electronics are sitting behind this or in front of this, whichever you want to say. Yeah, so they're sitting down there. We've got this extra piece here that juts out and creates a little container area for wheel weight, about 180 grams worth. You see behind there, so I've managed to stick them all inside there and all up the sides and everything to add a load of weight at the front and sort of lower down in the chassis where the battery would be, or where a side mounted battery would be. So it's got a load more front end weight, and I could tell during the G6 it handled so much better. It wasn't tipping back so much, and in general had a lot more grip at the front. You can't actually see it unless you look down behind the bumper or behind the servo. You can just about see it there. So it's all jammed inside that little area down there. And it doesn't impede the movement of the axle either, which is very, very good. With it being made out of 2mm stainless steel as well, it's a lot heavier than the aluminium. So just in itself, these components were a lot heavier. And then with the added wheel weights, we've added a load more weight at the front, and it just performs a lot better. That's a look at everything that we've removed and replaced in this episode of the Trail Project. Got all the old battery mounts and electronics mounts just there, and transmission, skid plate, and front drive shafts. So now I've got a solid drive line with the steel gears and the transmission and the upgraded heavy duty front drive shafts. So I have actually got a failure point in there, in being the centre drive shafts here, the stock axial ones, the plastic. So if there is a lot of strain in the system, those drive shafts are going to break before anything else. And those drive shafts are super easy to replace. It's just two grub screws, the drive shaft comes off and you can swap in a new one. So that is intentional. I do want that breaking point there, because if I start stripping gears in the transmission, the steel ones, or start breaking the drive shafts in here, they're going to be a lot more expensive to replace. So having a cheap breakable part, plastic part, in the drive line is always best, just so you've got a breaking point. And it's the same with the steering setup at the front as well. I've still got the stock plastic steering knuckles instead of aluminium ones. I don't want to be breaking or stripping out servo horns or these links. Just having a simple steering knuckle break, it's a lot easier to replace and a lot cheaper to replace than having any of these break. Just noticed my steering arm's a bit loose, but yeah. So that is it for this episode of the Trail Project. It is pretty much where I want it now. There's nothing else that needs doing to it. It handles like I want it to, and it looks pretty cool, so I'm happy with it as is. Thank you very much for watching this episode of the Trail Project. If you want to check out the Facebook and Twitter pages, links are down below in the description box, and I shall see you next time on RC Projects. Bye.
Yeah.